Доброе утро. Good morning. Добро пожаловать на мой канал. Welcome back to Russian with Nastya. And the word of the day is история. Давайте напишем. Let's write it down. История. What is история? История. История. What is история? Write in chat. Translate it in chat. This is the word of the day. История. Доброе утро. Yes, it's history. It's history, but also we use this word when we want to, to tell a story. History and just a story. История, история, history and story. It's very important. Memorize that. History and story. История. Скажите, say, история. Очень хорошо, молодцы, отлично. So today we are going to learn some poems by Pushkin, some parts of his poems. Which contains Russian hissing consonants. Russian hissing consonants are Ж, 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 Ча, Ча, Ша, and Ша, Ша. They can be very challenging in pronouncing in words. So this is why today we are going to learn some poems, some parts of the poems that contains these letters. And the first part is Лисов. Okay, actually in the first sentence there is no hissing consonant, but I took this part of the poem because we will see some words after this first sentence. Лисов таинственная сень. Let's write it down. Please prepare a notebook. Have a notebook with you. And always write with me. It's very important. So, the first sentence. Лисов таинственная сень. Лисов. Лисов. Then I will translate it. Лисов таинственная. Таинственная. It's a very popular Russian, very popular Pushkin's poem in Russian. Лисов таинственная, таинственная, таинственная сень, сень. Лисов таинственная сень. Скажите, say, лисов таинственная сень. Don't forget to practice with me out loud and try to copy my pronunciation. Лисов таинственная сень. The secret canopy of wood. Canopy, it's like what you see if you are up and you look at the forest. This is like a hat. Yeah, this is таинственная, secret canopy of wood. Лис, of woods. Лисов таинственная сень. Лисов таинственная сень. Next sentence. С печальным шумом обнажалась. So here we have three hissing consonants. С печальным. Пишем. Let's write it down. С печальным. Hissing consonant. С печальным. С печальным шумом, 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 с печальным шумом, first, second, с печальным шумом обнажалась, обнажалась. обнажалась, с печальным шумом обнажалась. Another hissing consonant. С печальным шумом обнажалась. With grievous noise became all naked. Обнажалась. When you became all naked. С печальным шумом. С печальным... with a very sad noise. With a very sad noise. Became all naked. With a sad noise. Became all naked. С печальным шумом, шумом обнажалась. С печальным шумом обнажалась. And here we have a rule. I will write it here. After these consonants, we can't write some letters. There are U, U, and Ya. We can't write these letters after hissing consonants. We can't write U, U, Ya after hissing consonants, except some exceptions. I talked about these exceptions in my first video about hissing consonants. There are some words, but they're not some everyday words, so I will not repeat them right now. If you are curious, you can go to that video and watch it. Хорошо, дальше. So we have лесов таинственная сень. No hissing consonants here. С печальным шумом обнажалась. With a sad noise became all naked. С печальным шумом обнажалась. Ложился на поля туман. Давайте напишем. Ложился на поля туман. This poem we study in school. It's a very common, very popular Russian poem by Pushkin. Ложился на поля туман. Ложился на поля туман. So, no ы after hissing consonants. Here you hear ы, right? We don't pronounce e here. Ложился, ложи, ы, ы. But we are not allowed to put ы here. No e after hissing consonants. After ж or ш or щ. Always e. Ложился, although you hear ы, write e. Ложился на поля туман. Here we have only one hissing consonant. Спасибо большое. Ложился на поля туман. So this is the first part. Let's read it one more time. Лесов таинственная сень. С печальным шумом обнажалась. Ложился на поля туман. Oh, I didn't translate this one. The fog... Туман, the fog was falling on the fields. The fog was falling on the fields. Ложился, to fall or to lay down. The fog was laying down or falling on the fields. На поля, on the fields. Okay, хорошо. Next part. Let's continue. Дальше. This is another one. This is from Евгений Онегин. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. Let's write it down. Теснятся. Then I will translate it. Теснятся барышни. Missing consonants here. Барышни, барышни, Барышни теснятся, барышни к Татьяне. Татьяне. If you didn't read this book, read it because it's very interesting. Евгений Онегин. I don't know how it is called in English. Eugene Onegin, maybe something like that. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. It's very interesting. It's a very interesting poem. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. Барыш. When you pronounce sh or же, you have to touch with your tongue your alveoli. Your tongue should be up. Sh, but not your teeth. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. Around Таня. Татьяна из Таня. Around Таня. Ladies crowd. Барышни are ladies. This old word for ladies. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. They are crowd her. They are around her. Дальше. Мужчины против и крестясь. Мужчины. Here you will see what is happening in this word. Мужчина is a man, right? Мужчины. Мужчины. Here this ж and ча we will pronounce as ща. Мужчины. Men. Мужчины. Против. Are against. Против. For example, мы против, we are against something. Да? Мы против, we are against something. Here men are against. Мужчины против. Мужчины против. И крестясь and making how to say cross, making cross, yeah, крестясь and making this cross. И крестясь толпа жужжит за стол садясь. They're making cross because they are preparing to have dinner, yeah, and before dinner they say praying and making a cross. И крестясь, толпа жужжит, so men are against and making a cross. Толпа is a crowd. Толпа жужжит. When you have double consonants, double hissing consonant, that means that you have to pronounce it deeper, longer. Жужжит. Толпа жужжит. That means in English we say humming. It's like you hear that they're talking, but you don't really hear what they're talking about. Just, yeah, something like that. This means жужжит. Жужжит, we say it about a bee. Bee is making this noise. This is what it means. Толпа жужжит. The crowd is humming. They're making this noise. Толпа жужжит. За стол садясь. За стол. Стол. Садясь. За стол садясь. Maybe it's too complicated for you, but I mean, this is Pushkin, and I think it's very interesting to learn some of his poems, although you will not understand all the words, but I'm trying to translate them to you. Толпа жужжит, so people are talking and making this noise, they're talking, but you hear like something like that, да? Толпа жужжит. За стол садясь. And takes the seats around the table. За стол садясь. За стол садясь. Taking the seats around the table. За стол садясь. So, let's read it one more time. Don't forget to practice with me out loud. Теснятся барышни к Татьяне. Мужчины, men, против. И, крестясь, толпа, the crowd, жужжит. За стол садясь. Угу, очень хорошо. Окей, дальше. Let's continue. Okay, and here we have a part of from the poem Gypsies by Pushkin. It's a very beautiful poem. Горит огонь. Горит. Давайте напишем. Горит. Горит. Огонь. Огонь. Горит огонь. There, here they mean a bonfire. Горит огонь. The bonfire glimmers. Горит is on fire. Yeah? Горит огонь. Семья кругом. The family is around. Семья sitting like near the bonfire. Семья кругом. Семья. Семья, family. Кругом. 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 From the word круг, a circle. Кругом. They are sitting like that in a circle. Семья кругом. Горит огонь. The bonfire glimmers. Семья кругом. The family is sitting around. Семья кругом. Готовит ужин. Cooking dinner. Готовит. Готовит. Готовит ужин. Ужин. Here the same. We hear ы, we hear ы, but we have to write и. Pronounce ы, but write и, because you are not allowed to put ы after hissing consonants. Ужин. Dinner. Готовит ужин. Cooking dinner. В чистом поле. In the clear field. В чистом поле means that there is nothing but the field. В чистом поле. В чистом, чистом, чистом поле. Literally, in the clean field, basically it means in the field, nothing is there, just a field. В чистом поле, в чистом поле. Пасутся кони, пасутся пасутся кони. Кони are horses. Пасутся кони. Пасутся кони. Пасутся, this is a word for when the animals are eating grass. This is пасутся. Let's see how you translate it here. Pasture. Pasture. Пасутся кони. The horses are eating grass. Пасутся кони. За шатром. За шатром. Шатром. Шатер is this house for where gypsies live, like a tent or something like that. Behind the tents, за шатром, behind these gypsies' houses. They look like tents. Yeah. За шатром. Ручной. Медведь, ручной медведь, ручной. Пушкин is using a lot in his poems bears. He's talking a lot about bears. Ручной, ручной медведь, медведь, ручной медведь. Речной медведь is the tame bear. The bear that is that is living around people is like a dog. Ручной, tame, ручной медведь лежит на воле. Лежит, is lying, лежит. Лежит на воле. На воле. Лежит на воле. He's lying in the на воле in the freedom. Like he's not tied to something. He's lying there in freedom. Лежит на воле. Ручной медведь. Ручной, it's руки. It's from the word руки, hands. So it's handy bear. It means that you can touch him. You can play with him, yeah, he's a tame bear, да, ручной медведь лежит на воле. If you can find this poem on the internet, it is called Gypsies, it's a very nice poem. Let's read it one more time and we are done. Горит огонь, семья кругом, готовит ужин в чистом поле. Пасутся кони за шатром, ручной медведь лежит на воле. Окей, okay. Yes, domesticated. О, спасибо, yes. Ручной медведь, domesticated bear. Очень хорошо. Спасибо большое за внимание. Thank you for your attention. If you like this video, let me know in comments or like it, so I know that you like it and I will make more videos like this. Спасибо за внимание. Thank you for your attention. И увидимся с вами через 5 минут. See you 5 minutes with another lesson. Спасибо. Yes, Morgan, a lot of words. We still use a lot of words, right? We still, I don't know. We use all these words, actually. Yeah. No, it's a, if maybe we don't use, but still you have to know this word, барышня, lady. We used to call that ladies. We Russians used to call like that ladies in the past, but still sometime as a joke, people can use it. Also, you can meet it in Russian books, in Russian poems. Да. Хорошо, все, всем пока. Спасибо большое. Thank you very much. Всем пока, целую. See you in 5 minutes. Чмоки-чмоки.